I'd like to tell you about a little state machine framework for property-based testing. So property-based testing, or QuickCheck, is usually presented with an example along these lines. So here I'm using the QCheck framework for OCaml. A test in this setup requires two things, a generator and a property. In this case, the generator is composed with a couple of combinators to form something that can output and produce integer lists. And for each such integer list, I then want to check this property that if I convert one of the lists to a sequence and back again, I get something that structurally equals the original list. So test.make will happily repeat this generation testing loop 100 times, but of course that's a parameter that you can crank it up if you would want to do so. That's very nice for functional code, but how about for imperative code? Say this little selection from the standard library Hashtables. There's the ability to create a new Hashtable, to add an entry, to remove an entry, and to look up an entry with find. How would you property-based test something like that? Well, we could try to come up with algebraic properties that say, if I first add foo and subsequently look up foo with find, I get back whatever I added. Or we could generate a random sequence of calls, which I'll call commands, and I'll represent them symbolically. And then I want to ensure somehow that each such command in the sequence works as expected. So diagrammatically, I want to do something like this. Here's a random sequence for you. Add A, add Z, find B, remove A, find C. And then I want to interpret each such command over the Hashtable implementation. I initially create a new one, and then I interpret an add as Hashtable add, and so on and so forth. Secondly, I write a model, a little declarative specification that describes abstractly the state of the Hashtable in this case. And as a model here, I'll use an association list of key value pairs that are in there. So when I add, and I want to interpret that command over my model, I then add that little key value pair to my association list, and so on. And finally, when there's output from these operations to compare, so add and remove both return units, so that not much to compare there, but at least find, looking up things with find, I can compare those outputs from the implementation and the model. Of course, to do something like this, I'll then need two interpreters of my symbolic commands and some agreement checking logic. So the nice thing about this setup is all of a sudden we lift the randomization to test arbitrary combinations of such commands. And sometimes there will bugs may lurk at the intersection between two commands. Of course, you can write something like this from scratch, and you're welcome to do so. So QCSTM is a little framework that I wrote that hopefully will make it simpler. So I'm teaching property-based testing or QuickCheck, and looking around, I found a number of frameworks supporting this, this approach for other languages that we like to compare OCaml to, say Haskell, Scala, Erlang, F#, and so on. But there was no such framework for OCaml. So as part of this teaching, I then wrote a little one. And my hope here is that perhaps some of you may find use of it as well. So, but first, an example. However, I'll need to briefly touch a bit about how QCheck generators work underneath the hood. So you saw a generator like SmallNat, And in QCheck, that has type int arbitrary. Arbitrary is a composite type, so it can generate things, but it also has other entries, say an optional entry to print any counterexample we may encounter, and an optional shrinker for cutting down, for reducing counterexamples. So as such, it's defined as a record type. You see there in line one, well, there is the sort of pure generator that I'd like to call it, and then the other entries. So to distinguish the two, I then call the full shebang, full bells and whistles generator, the record type, a full generator, as opposed to the pure generator there, gen, in line one. All right, so commands. Well, for hash tables, we'll first need to choose concrete types since the hash tables are polymorphic. So here I'll use char keys and integer values, and I can write a little algebraic data type there to represent add, remove, and find commands symbolically. And you'll notice here that I'm using PPX to derive a little string coercion routine, and that works very nicely. Now, using the gen submodule from QCheck, I can then write a little generator that chooses between generating an add command, generating a remove command, generating a find command using gen.oneOf. And you'll may notice here that I have phrased these in terms of a little character generator char gen let bound there in line two. And I can then pair this pure generator up with my auto-derived printer to form a full generator of command arbitrary type. All right, so the model, I can express my association list type char times int list as so. Now I can write a little interpreter, one command interpreter over my model. So given a command C, I interpret an add instruction by adding the key value pair to my association list. I interpret a remove command using list.removeAsoc from the standard library. And this way I faithfully modeled shadowing of OCaml's hash tables. Find, however, has no side effect. It doesn't change the state of hash tables, so it just leaves S unmodified. All right, I can then write the second interpreter over the system under test. And well, in our case, we want the system under test is hash tables from chars to integers. I interpret an add command here by calling hashtable.add. I interpret a remove by calling hashtable remove, and I interpret a find by calling hashtable.find. In the first two cases, they return a unit. So to satisfy this second job of run command to return a bool that signals whether there's agreement or not between the model and the system under test, I just return true in these two cases. However, in the third case, I use a little exception handler to catch the case if hashtable.find should throw an exception, and then convert that to an option that I can then compare to the output of list.asoc opt. All right, so overall in the framework, it expects a module that satisfies this interface. There's a command type. It expects a state type that it expresses the model. It expects a type for the system under test. And then, well, it expects a full generator of commands. It expects init state to initialize the model. And it expects a one command interpreter over the model. for the system under test. It expects a hook to initialize the system under test and to reset it, and then it expects a run command, which will both interpret a command over the system under test and check agreement, so it returns a boolean. Precond I'll get back to in a bit. All right, you may have noticed there that I changed the generator's type signature slightly to accept a state parameter. And that is handy, say, to increase our chance of generating previous keys like add Z and then later generate a find Z. So if there is any previous entries in my association list, well, I can list.map over the model to extract that list of keys, and then with, in this case, 50% chance, choose between generating one of these or falling back on random generation of characters. And so this was a full generator, but I can then pair that up again with my printer, just passing along the state parameter to have this state-dependent full generator. All right. So the example that we've seen, we can now satisfy that signature by putting everything together on one slide like this. You may notice here that I satisfy the init state by just setting it to the empty association list, and I initialize my system under test by creating an empty hash table, disabling randomization for repeatability of my tests. All right, so if I do so, provide this to this functor QCSTM, what you get back is a module with a signature with some of these entries. So you get back a full generator now over command lists. You'll get back a recursive agreement checker that of course needs the model as a parameter and the system under test that, the system that we're testing, and returns a boolean to signal whether there is agreement between the two or not. And then as a little shorthand, agree test will then use both of these. So here's the hash table example using the latter one. HT for hash table test, agree test, I provide a count parameter, I want to run this 500 times, and I provide a name for this test, and that works very nicely. What does it? Well, how can we be sure, Jan, you ask? Well, we could inject an error and then confirm whether it is caught or not. So here I inserted a silly mistake like ignoring inserts of the value 89. So if I recompile my test suite and run, you'll see, aha, here's a counterexample for you. If I add the key R with the mysterious value 89 and then later try to look it up, there is disagreement between the model and the system under test. And you may notice here that the example has been shrunk. It has been reduced in this case in 15 steps down to a minimal one. All right, preconditions. Sometimes some of these commands may have preconditions. Say perhaps you only want to test the Queue.pop operation when there is something in the queue, but it could also be a database or a file handle or a socket or something like that that has to be open as a precondition for a command. Using this state parameter, if we model whether such a connection is open or not in in the model, we can express that. However, once the shrinker kicks in, unfortunately, it may break these kinds of invariants. So therefore, precondition is a little hook to express whether a given command is acceptable in a given state. And the shrinker then uses that. All right. So this was a very, very minimal example, I know. But I've tried to test run the framework on a number of examples from the property-based testing literature and a few other ones as well. So all in all, this spans both OCaml code, a few puzzles, and actually also some C code. For OCaml code, at least, it doesn't take more than 10 to 13 lines of code per tested command, which I think is decent. All right, related work. Academically, this idea of using models goes all the way back to Hoare. Of course, there's the classic QuickCheck paper from ICFP 2000, but 2 years later, Claassen and Hughes suggested using models to test monadic code, inspired by label transition systems and model-based testing. Koopman and Plasmeier, then the year after, presented the first state machine framework for clean. And then a few years later again, the first version for Erlang QuickCheck EQC commands came out. Since then, that has been revised, and a number of others have come and joined. There's one little paper here that I think is very interesting. Koopman, Achten, and Plasmeier tried to do a apples to apples comparison between this using logical properties compared to using state machines, like you've seen here. And their conclusion is actually, well, that they are both powerful approaches, but the state machines are slightly more effective at bug finding. So that's all the more reason for us to have a framework for OCaml. All right, so overall, I tried to introduce to you a little typed state machine framework for property-based testing in OCaml. It builds on the QCheck framework, and it's open source under a liberal BSD license. You can find the source code there. I developed the thing as part of a course that I'm teaching on property-based testing. And in that context, once I made a little OPAM package, it became a breeze for students. OPAM installed QCSTM, worked wonderfully, even on the Windows machines with this Windows subsystem for Linux. So hooray, thank you, OPAM people, for making that possible. I'm open to suggestions, ideas for applications of the thing, but other than that, thank you for listening.